The remarks I'm about to make is just to provoke debate on the current constitutional amendments going on so that we really get to have the right kind of local government system in the country. I was very, very touched when the chairman, Ken Namani, paid glowing tribute to Enugu state government and also the local government system in this state. I want to say that the opposite is the case in my state. And I believe my state is not the only state. We not only don't have a functional local government system, we even do not have a functional state system. I am very, very pleased and honored to be invited to this national conference on rediscovering the Nigerian local government system in the emerging constitution. I thank the organizers of this conference and the leadership of ALGO for inviting me and for selecting me for this very important theme. I am also reminded that this is also the 13th anniversary of the formation of ALGO. That anniversary does bring back good memories to me. I recall playing a role as the then vice president in the formation of this association. In fact, I was among those who actively encouraged its formation. I did so because of my deep belief in the viability, importance, and effectiveness of local administration. I believed then and still believe now that local leaders across the country needed to have a forum for interaction, for exchange of ideas, and for promotion of healthy rivalry to spur development and best practices in administration and management. I also thought that our local leaders needed a strong collective voice for constructive intervention in national decision making relating to local administration and other related matters. In fact, I recall that when I inaugurated ALGON on 30th November 1999 at the African Women's Center, Abuja, the main objectives of forming the association were listed as, among others, the promotion and protection of the rights, privileges, interests, and autonomy of local governments for the ultimate survival of the local government councils in Nigeria. I am glad that many of those objectives have been realized and that you have sustained this spirit and momentum. I heartily congratulate all of you today. But clearly, challenges remain. There is still a lot of work to be done. There are still objectives to be met and goals to attain. An issue at the forefront of current discussion on constitutional amendment is the autonomy of local governments. Nigeria's local governments still lack reasonable autonomy to provide services and implement development projects for the local populations in an efficient and timely manner. Taking a cue from the overbearing federal government, state governments have been overbearing in their relationship with local administrations as well. Many have been abusing the joint state-local government accounts by tampering with local government funds, as reports and petitions make clear. Interestingly, while these abuses go on, many local government leaders are unable to say so for fear of angering their state governments and governors. The direct allocation of funds from the federation account to local government was meant to ensure that the local governments get development funds from the center in order to enhance their operational capacity. At the same time, the joint state LG account was meant to acknowledge the rightful role of the federating states in local government administration. However, the control that the state governments have over the joint accounts has ensured that the development objective of the direct allocation is not met. And it has left the local government worse off than they were prior to that policy shift. While most agree that this is a problem, there is a divergence of opinions on what the proper relationship between the three tiers of government should be. The most popular seems to be the call for constitutional amendment to guarantee local government autonomy, especially on the question of the joint account of state governments. The claim here is that the abolition of the joint account will ensure that governors will not tamper with local government funds. However popular that may seem at the moment, it may not be a very smart idea going forward. Think about it. The temptation to enshrine in the Constitution the nature of the relationship between the three tiers of government, especially in a manner that seeks to sidestep the state governments, may lead to more problems for local administration than seems apparent now. I believe that we need to re-examine our conception of local government administration. And I believe that is why you are here gathered today. There are questions which I will ask you, and you ought to answer them yourselves. Should we continue with the practice of the federal government creating local governments across the country and allocating resources to them directly? Or should it be left in the hands of federating states to decide for themselves the system of local government and the number of local government authorities they need because of our historical and cultural differences? Remember, in the First Republic, we all had different systems of local government administrations. The one from the north was different from the one from the east, and the east was also different from the one from the west. In my view, there are three critical issues here. First is the structure of our federation. The second is our political practice. And the third is our disregard for rules and regulations. In a federation, local administration ought to be left in the hands of federating states or regions, rather than an awkward situation where the local governments deal directly with the federal government while sidetracking the state government. The federating unions should be left to determine the system and number of local governments and fund them accordingly in accordance with their historical and cultural peculiarities and developmental needs.